Large parts of Melbourne are being left without specialist paramedics, and the ambulance union admits it's costing lives. As Lana Murphy explains, it's being blamed on staff shortages and a surge in 000 calls during the pandemic.
They're the best of the best, but MICA paramedics can't be in two places at once. And with fewer of them on the road, its own workforce admits critically ill patients are paying the price.
It is a matter of life and death.
Grappling with an unprecedented number of 000 calls and an exhausted workforce, Ambulance Victoria is short-staffed. Some paramedics are paired up with students, travelling up to 100 kilometres to reach a patient, and its most highly trained mobile intensive care ambulance paramedics are bolstering the numbers.
They're just being sent to patients with back pain, intoxicated patients, patients who are vomiting. That's not what they're there for. They're there to deal with the most time-critical cases, and because resources are stretched so thin, they're not available to respond to those when they come up.
Why should Victorians accept people are going to die because the government has failed? They've failed to put in the investment and the planning. It's not good enough. We're not a third world country.
One third of Melbourne's population was left without MICA coverage on Friday night. Preston, Altona, Central Melbourne, Roxburgh Park and Hillside had no staff to roster on, leaving crews in Tarneit and Sunshine to cover the entire area. A trial to reserve MICA crews only for life and death cases began on the same day, but was abandoned after 1 hour because there wasn't enough staff.
We see regularly the entire western suburbs of Melbourne having no MICA coverage at all.
We've got world's best paramedics in Victoria. Essentially, we need more of them.
Ambulance Victoria says the sickest patients will always be prioritised and receive the highest quality care. It's recruiting more paramedics and upskilling existing ones, but those on the ground say supply will never meet demand.
Demand on the system is just huge. Too many people are calling 000. No matter how many hospitals you build, we'll fill them.
Lana Murphy, Nine News.